All right, today we're checking out Blue Oyster Cult. We'll listen to the song, I'm Burning For You. Let's get into it.
Cult.
Yeah,
I love how they're just like easy listening, you know. Just like,
yeah, it is really easy to listen to.
Yeah, ooh, I really like the vibes. And then like every time they're like, oh, in my head I'm always like, oh.
Are you talking about the intro?
Yeah, well, like that part where they start doing this, like, oh, it's like at this transition. I don't know, but there's a part where they start doing like this, oh.
Because remember the intro was like heavy on the uhs too, remember?
Yeah.
I was thinking during the intro. Okay. I was like, oh, this sounds like the music that would be playing at like the pearly gates for rock and metal fans.
Oh.
You know what I mean? So it was like you had the instrumental, but then you had the, oh. You know,
yeah,
that's literally,
yeah,
what I was thinking. Which,
yeah,
has nothing to do with anything, but that's what was going through my head.
I'm not the one to tell you what's wrong.
Okay, so what do you think overall?
I liked it. I thought it was good. I like how Blue Oyster Cult, I don't know, is how do you differentiate? They're definitely rock, but it's much
more different,
right? But it's not Southern rock, even though they do a lot of Southern-ish sounds, you know. Okay. But I don't know how to differentiate. But there's definitely it's not easy listening makes me think of jazz, and it's definitely not that.
Well, you're trying to differentiate the wrong thing.
Okay.
It's not about rock or metal or Southern rock or this subgenre, this, that, jazz, hip-hop. Doesn't matter. It's about good music, bad music.
Okay.
That's it. Can you differentiate between those two?
Well, yeah, of course.
And bad being a subjective term. You know what I mean? Bad to someone else may be good to someone else. But for you, good, bad, boom. Where's it fall?
Good.
Okay, good. You did it. That's all you got to figure out.
No, but that's so easy.
That's all you got to figure out. Then you also got to figure out which playlist does it go on. That's the harder part, you know. Trying to get it on a playlist where the vibe is nice, so it's almost like an album. Or just listen to an album. But the thing that stood out the most to me about the song, and the most interesting, was the structure of the verses.
Why?
It was almost like spoken word or something, like the structure.
Yeah.
Like, remember it was like home, home, home. Like, each line started with home, except the last one or something.
Oh.
And they did the same thing with time on the second verse.
See, I didn't pay attention to that, really.
And if you literally just took those verses and read it, it would be like spoken word. Did you see someone does a spoken word with that?
Yeah.
Or that kind of structure?
So I wonder if they're like, if this is a musician's song then. You know what I mean? Like, you know how some songs are like made for the sort of, to give you a certain feeling, but they're kind of, the words don't matter. And then other songs, like, I wonder if they did something with the rhythm and the flow of the song. You know what I mean?
No.
Like, I'm saying like what you just said.
Yeah, they did something with the rhythm of the song.
But
what are you asking?
I'm saying when they made this song, like, you know, every song that anyone ever makes has some kind of point to it.
Yes.
But a lot of times the point will be, I want you to feel this, or I want to, you know, I want to reflect what it's like to be depressed or whatever. But what if this one was a musician's song and it was about like, I want to have this cool rhythm and this, you know what I mean? Like, what if it was like nuggets like that?
Oh, I think so. I mean, I don't think it was an accident.
Do
it
like musical poetry.
Yeah.
Like, a sort of, yeah.
I think it's that on top of all the regular stuff musicians do.
Yeah.
Self-expression, I thought, is like the main thing artists do. They're just expressing themselves.
Right.
You know?
I think you caught something interesting, though. I didn't really pay attention to that, but they wouldn't do that for no reason, you know?
Yeah, yeah.
And I bet when they were creating the song, instead of starting with, like, a riff or starting with, like, a sentence or something, they probably started with, like, phrase chunks.
All right, can you spoken word these lyrics for me?
Home in the valley, home in the city. Home isn't pretty, ain't no home for me.
Exactly. Doesn't that sound like spoken word?
Boom. It is.
Boom. Home in the darkness, home on the highway.
Ooh.
Home isn't my way, home I'll never be. Mm. You know what I'm saying?
I don't know. Tell me, man, what do you know?
What do you know?
Me and my boys on the road. You the go. She told me, boy, you the go. Like, I don't know. But I don't.